Now what we got here in the background is backgrounds. How about that? This is, I was calling South Slope Mine, this little area here. And I'll actually put it in here so you guys can look at it. I do have the light fixture in place right here. I don't actually have it wired up and I don't have the rest of it done. So once I get this in, it'll shine up really nice up in here. And these are actually sitting lower. I got to notch these to fit around these shelving brackets here and here. You can see that. And this will actually fit up and further back. Even though I do have, so I'll slide these down here, a background in place. I figured it might be just a little bit easier to just glue this stuff on other panels and mount these over the panels that I have. Basically what I use is like a picture mounting style glue that I bought from, I guess, Michaels. To mount my backgrounds, I've used that 3&M photo mount, and because they were shiny paper, I used that Valspar clear flat. I thought it was Krylon clear flat, but that's what I've used. Sprayed it down, stuck this background to it, I trimmed it up to fit. So this area here, if you look, which kind of helped me come up with the color for the mine that will be here pretty soon, is I got a green mine with a red roof. And over here, on this corner here, we have a red mine with a silver rusty roof. This is actually the color I'm going to do for that mine. The sad part about some of these drawings, or backgrounds, is things like this little station here. I got to figure out a way to get rid of that. I don't want that in here. This little steam engine here, I really don't want that in there. I could probably do something to hide that. And this wood trestle. Got to figure out what I'm going to do with that. The other thing that I've done is I've taken, it's a Krylon flat. I spray painted it flat once it's stuck in place. It stopped the reflections. It was shiny paper. And you might still get a little reflections off of it. But, you know, it's better to be a little bit dull than not reflect at all. This little mine here, I'll be doing on the corner. Maybe later on I'll show you guys. I'll be doing a little mine. I'm going to be using the New River mine and that little extra 3-bin type of loader. I'm going to paint it up like this with the green with the red. I'm going to put it at the far end of this little middle level that we don't see. I'll put it in here in a minute so you can look at it. That's going to be at the far end of the noose, and it's going to be called Knot Mine, K-N-O-T-M-I-N-E, the Knot Mine. For the knot of noose, but it's actually kind of funny as in it's not mine, but that's what that's going to be. Like I said, I'm going to paint the actual mine that sits here the red and the with silver roof to kind of match. Figure out what I'm going to do with that. This trestle deal has probably got to go away, and I'll just kind of continue this background up that ramp. This is the reason why I haven't been posting videos. I should be doing a build on this section. This is what I was calling the North Slope Mine or whatever. I have a hard time saying that. Got a lisp or something going on. I've actually changed this because I put the backgrounds that you just saw a little bit earlier. I'm going to call this Red Mesa Mine. Like I said, I'm going to paint the mine red, which will fit back here. You can see if I right underneath here, I've already got my switch machines in place. I've got a lot of the wiring done on it. I've weathered the track. Did some ballast work and everything, but this is kind of what's holding me up. I kind of got to get this done. This is kind of my scenery stuff. I'm not too hot at doing scenery and ballasting track. So I got to get this whole middle section done, and I've kind of lacked on doing the videos and stuff. This would have actually been a good video to do for you guys, so I might go back and show you guys a little bit about what I did and when I get it installed. But this is kind of a look at what I'm doing, and this is going to be Red Mesa Mine. Granted, this is just a stand-in, but it gives you a good idea what it's going to look like when I get all this stuff installed. As you can't see back here, I'm going to actually put a mirror on the back side of this, so if you look through the loading bays, you'll actually see the mirror, and it'll look like it extends out a little bit further that direction into that valley that's in the backdrop. I got my three tracks, which are probably like small, medium, large, what do they call it, nut, egg, or whatever the different coal sizes are. It really doesn't matter. I'm going to end up painting this red with the silver to match the background. Here, I actually have, as I knocked my car off the track, here's where the scale is. I've ordered a little scale building to go right here for scale house. So after they load, you'll have to bring a couple cars. It's kind of tedious where it's at. So, you know, if you got six cars in here, two out of six, you'll have to, if you're running this place, you'll have to bring them over to the scale, put them on the track, weigh them, and move them on. I also have a little scale test car that I'll use here, you know, part of the operation sessions that, you know, once or twice, you know, a year's frame, time frame, you'll have to bring the little scale car here and actually verify the scale. I have a scale that I'm actually going to put in up at Gila Grains too, which I never thought about, but somebody said something, I go, you know, that'd be a good spot for a scale. So I'm going to put a scale over there too, so I can run that little scale car, you know, one session and go down here, next session go back to the yard where it's stored, session after that would go up to there. So you get basically every 4 months it makes kind of a full round robin tour of the layout. You know, that's three times a year, give or take, that it moves around here. It's not that many times. I don't think people notice it that much, but it's enough to add a little bit of variety to my operations and everything. But as you can see, I still need to do a lot of work here. This is the main. They'll loop around and up the slope up into the helix, which eventually will be a big deal video that I have done. I've been working on that helix section and this ramp for a few months now. And I really want to get all this track work in place before I actually start that video, or actually finish it. I think you guys will like that. Like I said, this should have been a video. It's just that I don't have the time. I'm really after getting this done. So within the next month or so, I should have this all done, track in, weather this stuff and everything. Just show you where we're coming from again. That over there is Red Mesa with Red Mesa Mine. It'll work its way around here in this middle level. This is the other switching area. I shouldn't say switching area. It's a type of crossover. You'll see it as we get it done. It'll be a double track loop here with the ability to cross over because it's a turnaround at the very end. It's a reversing loop. And right here, there'll be another track for a helper locomotive that I'm going to end up sitting some helpers here just in case something can't make it up the helix, which is over there in an upcoming video. So I'll probably be using some sort of these backgrounds again along this upper area. The level will run probably right about this height. Let me back up here so you can see. Over the Adobe Pass area, it'll be a two-track, about that wide. You know, so I'll run something here. You know, I'll probably move a background up or down. Use one of these dry wash type desert or something like that. I haven't figured out what I'm actually going to use down here, but I'll probably somehow fit this little green mine down here. And this is out of basin, this is out of but this is a New River little 3-bay coal tipple deal. So just like here in this lower level, I'll wrap around, do the reverse loop, and come back and back around and through. So this is not mine. I'll end up fitting in the lower loop of Noose. Kind of, I don't know, not mine, whatever. But the only reason why Noose has got its name is if you look at it from above, when it's actually laid out, it looks like a hangman's noose. In fact, that looks really good. I kind of like that scenery. It's got a nice effect to it. So I think I'll probably do something like this. There's one called a cactus desert. which I might use all along here, and then go to the this section here at the very end with the mine right here, down at that far in the noose. This is Drexel Hill, where the floor slopes down. If you look down there, that's what I call my water gauge. It's just a piece of inkjet paper. I have a sump pump outside. When we used to have heavy rain, this little section right here would get all flooded because it was just low enough to get water in here. But with that sump pump, and I've put downspouts and everything, so I haven't had water in here in a long time, but that's my rain gauge. So if it gets blotty, I know I had water in here. Coming around South Yard. Oh, my major award. Not saying I'm an iPad ad fan, iPad 2, whatever it is, but I did win an iPad from work. So this is my major award. Because I'm not an Apple person or anything like that in any way, shape, or form, I'd have never gone out and spent the money to buy one of these. It's like $600, $700 for this thing. I will say now that I have it, I really do like it. I still would not spend the money on it. But because I've gone over to the dark side, if you recognize, good old Darth Vader there in the background. As you can see, the upper here up by Vermont. I had to take that down because I'm mounting stuff behind there for now. Vermont, all these areas are just kind of getting cluttered as I do work. Here's another neat little thing that I'm using. I'm using these little stone or brick walls. I think these are from Pike stuff or Rick stuff. The run that along here. And then I'll just end up stacking them a little bit all the way up, where it's kind of got a nice little staggered step look, so it looks a little bit better. Than I was going to put some sort of scenery along here. I might curve something back in this area here as I get up higher. Here it's going to be a little bit easier to put some rock cuts back in here. The problem is right here, the lower down track is actually above the main. So this will add a little bit of figuring out what I'm going to put here. Maybe a cut. Who knows what I'm going to put in here. As you've seen, there's the lights. Really nice. There's that helix I've been working on. So we'll be seeing that come into operation fairly soon. And there's a mess. This is kind of my work area, my shoes. I know you guys probably noticed I've got the little boxes in front of my layout with the little car cards and everything. I actually do operations on here, and that's kind of the goal. Is once I get that middle ramp section done, we can start doing a little bit of operations on here a little bit. That's the final piece to get that done. The reason why I'm in such a rush, you guys are interested, October of 2012, we're doing an Arizona Rail event here in Arizona. I believe it's going to be a 3-day event with the 4th optional day on Sunday. People that sign up and everything for this have an opportunity to run, I believe, 5 scheduled operating sessions, I believe, maybe a total of 6. It's like, I believe we have one on Thursday night. Let me think about this. One on Thursday night, Friday night, Saturday morning, Saturday night, and Sunday. Maybe it is another one Friday morning too. So it's an opportunity to get in a lot of operations here in Arizona and visit some layouts. You don't see many of our layouts here in Arizona in the press. It just happens that way, as most of the press, magazines, and stuff are back east. And like you can see, My layout's not even close to being done, but it will be operational. So I'll keep you guys posted on that if you guys are interested in running operating on a layout here in Arizona or live here in Arizona and would like to join the group and everything and possibly put your layout into a round robin group to run operations on. That'd be cool. So it's your opportunity to come see the GSNM or the Gila Springs Mesquite. Depends on what air or time frame I'm working on. Mostly it's right around mid to late 90s, so the GSNM, but we do still see some Gila Springs and Mesquite's colors floating around. And come operate with me. Thanks for watching.